Welcome to UOIT's Teaching and Learning Center's teachtorial on reading the Originality Report and Turnitin. This is one screencast in a series of teachtorials designed to help you use Turnitin by reviewing the Originality Report for matched text entries and how to interpret the results. Let's get started. I'm going to log in to Turnitin.com with my email address and password. I'm taken to the instructor homepage where I see a list of all my classes. The class that I'm looking at today is ABCD Class 1. I click on the class to go into the class homepage. The link that you're going to click on now is the View link. This takes you to the next page, which is called the Assignment Inbox. This is where you will find all of the assignments that your students have uploaded. We've uploaded two assignments, one chemical reactions and the other Freud and Skinner. You can have a look at their papers by simply clicking on the title of the paper, which then opens up the document viewer. And you can see the paper as it is without being marked up with any of the text that is similar to other sources. Over to the right-hand side, under Report, is what's called the Similarity Index. This percentage tells you how much of the report or how much of the paper has been plagiarized according to Turnitin. Keep in mind that Turnitin does not really detect plagiarism, but rather it detects text that is similar to another source in its repository. We'll have a look at the report in 1 minute, but just to help you understand the different colors and the percentages, Turnitin considers the following when it looks at the similarity index. Anything from 1 to 24% will be highlighted in green. Anything from 25 to 49% will be highlighted in yellow. Anything from 50 to 74%, such as these, are highlighted in orange. And anything above 74% will be highlighted in red. Gives you a vague idea of how Turnitin determines the similarity index and its relation to how much of the paper may be plagiarized. So I'm going to have a look at the chemical reactions paper, click on the percentage, and that takes me to the Originality Report. You're offered a window before you get to the actual report to give you a tutorial or a 4-minute walkthrough of the Originality Report. It's highly recommended to watch this. So here it is. What you've been waiting for. The Originality Report. On the left-hand side of the screen, you see the actual paper itself with highlighted areas that are the areas that Turnitin considers to have been plagiarized. On the right-hand side are the sources that matched to those entries on the left-hand side. So if we look at this paper, the first paragraph looks fine, no problem at all. The second paragraph, third paragraph, and most of the fourth paragraph have all been linked to source number one, which is over on the right-hand side, called www.gotessays.com. And you can see that 55% of this paper is matching to this website. On the right-hand side, you can get more details about the website that, or the internet source, or the publication, or a student paper, or whatever it's matched to, by clicking on the little arrow to the right of the percentage. It now shows you a list of other places where it has found similarities. This shows you that a certain number of different areas have taken work from gotessays.com. Notice on the left-hand side, it has expanded the text from the internet source itself so that you can compare it to the text in the paper. So here it says later in the 17th century, a German chemist named, and over here it says later in the 17th century, a German chemist named. So your student has copied this directly from this source. I can go back to see the other matches by clicking the arrow to the left of Match Breakdown. And if I wanted to see the second match, which is okcupid.com, I double click on it, and over on the right and left hand side, the paper opens up to the area where that text is similar. In this particular case, you notice that not all of the text has been copied, and somebody may have done a half-decent job of paraphrasing as opposed to actually stealing the text from someone else, in which case we would be looking at plagiarism. Note on the right-hand side that this particular internet source has been 12% used in this paper. Let's have a look at a publication. 1% of the paper has come from this publication here. Again, I can click on the arrow to go to that particular publication and see it showing up here. Well, this is not really an example of plagiarism, and this is why it takes a human eye to look at these originality reports as opposed to the percentages. Now, this is not a high percentage, it's at 1%, but if that was a higher percentage, you could say that maybe it's not all the way up to 71% similarity index, and you take into account that some of the similarities are perfectly acceptable. So that's one of the reports. Let's have a look at the second report, the Freud and Skinner. Again, I'm going over to where the similarity index is shown, and I'm going to click on the index to have the paper and its matches show up. On the left-hand side is the paper, on the right-hand side are the sources. And again, you can tell right away from this paper that this particular student has gone to an internet source called eCheat.com and has captured a lot of information. On the left-hand side, if I scroll through the paper, I can look at all the different ones, and I can see that was a huge source of information for this student. But there are other sources here, including student papers. When you click on the arrow for student papers, you get a message here. This was submitted to Westminster College. Your message says, because submitted papers remain the intellectual property of their authors, instructors, and respective institutions, we are unable to show you the content of this paper at this time. If you would still like to view this paper, please click on the link above to submit a permission request to the author's instructor. In other words, if you click on this link, you will be given an opportunity to submit an email to the student's instructor from this particular paper. Let's go back to the match breakdown and notice that there are two other papers that are similar. If I double click over here, I am taken to the area that is similar over on the left. And again, your eye tells you that's not a huge problem. The rest of the paper is, but this is not a huge problem. So number 6 I'm not too worried about. Number 5 looks like it's just taken it from a reference, and I don't see any other 5s throughout the paper, so 5 and 6 aren't a problem to me. Number 4 is 2%, and this is simply the use of the two names, and I don't see number 4, oh I do see number 4 showing up here, but I don't see that as a problem either. So the ones that are maybe becoming, well, the one that is a concern to you is the eCheat.com, and of course these are fictitious papers that have been created by the Teaching and Learning Department to show you how the plagiarism shows up in the originality report. This concludes our tutorial on reading the originality report in Turnitin. Thank you for watching.